Hello, welcome back. We are at day 5, and we're actually on day 2 of our mini series. So I'm doing mini series within a mini series. I know, whatever. Roll with it. I'm Christine, here with Christine Rose Photography, and this mini series is all about basically composition and communicating what you want your image to be with the viewer. Okay, so yesterday we talked about what is our subject. So hopefully at this point we've dived into that a little bit beyond the, oh, I'm shooting a landscape. And we've gone a little bit deeper into that. The second thing that I think about in every single photograph that I'm creating, why? What is the reason why I'm creating this image? Because if your answer is, it's pretty, I don't really care. And I mean no offense with that, but there's lots of pretty photos out there. If that's the only reason that you're taking the photograph, I'm probably not gonna look at it that long. I want more. And that more might be in the image visually. So for instance, there is a memorial just down the road from where I live. It's a Swissair Flight 111 memorial. And this is a flight that went down in the ocean, Swissair 111. The plane crashed and everyone died. And this was horrific. I remember it happening as a child. And there is a beautiful memorial right on the ocean. There are a lot of images created there. The why is going to be pretty visually apparent when you see an image from there and you know the monument. You don't necessarily need to have words attached to that image in order for the viewer to understand what's going on, given that they know what the monument is for. So anyone local would know, anyone else would need a little bit of an explanation. Other images might need a little bit more attached to it. And for me, this is a reason why when I'm scrolling through Instagram, taking a look around, and I come across a beautiful image and the photographer said nothing about it, I don't know that photographer. I probably just scrolled by. I kind of don't care that much because I don't know anything about the image. Like, why is it actually there? Is it just there to be pretty? All right, that's cool. It's a pretty place that I've never been to. I'm not gonna connect with it. So understanding why we're creating an image becomes very, very important. And this can, it can change across a variety of levels. So you can be creating work from a deep down level. So it can be something that is deep, deep inside you and it is overarching across all of the work that you do. Or you can sometimes be creating work for one very specific reason. And maybe, so if we're talking about night sky photography here, maybe you're connecting with a specific object in the night sky. So for instance, Orion is the winter constellation that most people know of. And it's one for me that I spent a lot of time as a child looking up at this constellation and really kind of escaping from my reality. And I connect with Orion on that level. So that's something of the why that I bring to it. And that is going to be communicated to my viewers. And that will make you care more about the image. So understanding that underlying why we're taking an image becomes paramount for your viewer to actually connect to your photos and to actually care about them. Now, I'll take this another direction just quick, because there will be times when you're not creating work for yourself. And that why becomes very important then. So I worked and ran a commercial photography studio for an international toy company for over a decade. My why to create those images is very different than my why to create images when I go out at night. I was creating images to sell. So I had to take this product and make it look as good as possible so that you want to buy it for your kids. That was my why. And that why drove the entirety of how I created these images. It was the way that I looked at the product, the way that I looked at my image, the gear choices that I made, the lighting choices that I made. All of those things came in together with my why. This comes back to night photography too. So if your why is all about the stars and your foreground doesn't have very much to do with it, your foreground's probably gonna be a silhouette. If your why is, let's say instead, attached to this place, and this place is very important, well, that place should have a little bit more of prominence in your image, shouldn't it? And we should be able to see it. So maybe it's lit with moonlight or with starlight, or you're using low-level lighting on it. All of this, all of these decisions, these technical decisions that come into play have to make sense with why we created the image. So don't skip this. And if you answered, I just want to take a pretty picture, I want you to challenge that and to think about it. And this is something that I have done recently, and it wasn't easy. I'm not gonna lie, it was not an easy thing to do, but I have a much deeper understanding of why I'm going out and creating the work that I am. So this is our second in our three-part mini-series. Come back tomorrow for the last part, okay? It's very important. And let me know about today. What do you think with taking your photos? Have you thought a lot about why you're doing it? Hit me up in the comments, send me a message. I want to hear more. Thank you so much.